everyone, welcome to the GRE How-To Series, where we make studying for the GRE a lot more tolerable. Today we are going to talk about data interpretation questions. There are a lot of those questions on the test, so if this is something you're interested in and you're interested in more content on the GRE, then you've come to the right place, and I think it's a good idea to subscribe because, you know, like, the party's just getting started over here. Not only are we going to have content on the GRE process, but also applying to grad school and the process and everything that has to do with the journey. So if you haven't already, join the Brilliant AF crew by clicking subscribe. And you know what? You can click the little bell as well so that you won't miss a beat. Stay tuned. Everyone, welcome back. And like I said, we're talking about the data interpretation questions. These questions tend to be, I would say, deceptive in some ways. Sometimes they're difficult, sometimes they seem easy, but if you're not paying attention, that's where things get a little tricky. Generally, you should expect to see about 6 data interpretation questions. It might present itself as a couple sets of data in the form of pie charts or graphs and things like that. And then you have 3 questions in which you're supposed to triangulate and try to answer those questions. Or it might just have 1 graph and have 3 questions on that. 6 questions represents 6 points, and that can make or break your score. So I want to make sure that I am giving you really useful tips for you to keep in mind as you're studying for the GRE. So the first thing I want you to do is understand what you're looking at. It's okay to take about 25 seconds to just digest the landscape of the data. And there are about 5 things that I want you to pay very close attention to. First are the titles and axes. These are tiny details, but it actually makes a huge impact if you misread one of them. So it's really important to internalize that because there could be some questions on the test that capitalize on whether or not you're paying attention to one of those aspects. The next thing I want you to take note of are how the values are actually represented. Are they the raw values, or maybe are they presented in percentages? That's going to come in handy because there's going to be something, I guarantee you, there's going to be something that's going to require you to either note how they're actually displayed or convert them into another form. So you want to know what you're working with from the very beginning. The third thing I think it's really important to keep in mind is the sum of the parts. When we're dealing with fraction or decimal conversions, things like that, there's going to be a denominator, and the denominator is going to be the sum of the whole. So it's important to just keep in mind what that is. Maybe if you can just eyeball that, or just know that that's something you might have to do in the very near future of the test. The fourth thing I want you to take notice is the general trend of the data, whether things are trending up, down, where are the highest points, where are the lowest points, because if you do encounter a question, you're going to know exactly where to look, and that's going to be really important. All of this, it's like getting ready to go on a journey and you're reading the cues on the map, so that when you know which direction you're supposed to go, you already are oriented and you know exactly how to navigate to get to the right answer. Lastly, it's gonna be really important you just pay attention to any of the ancillary details. I'm talking about footnotes especially. Those are the little tiny, tiny writing on the bottom of a graph or a page, and those typically include some key details that a question on the test may capitalize on if you don't take note of that. So those are the 5 things that you just want to make sure you understand before you even dive into the questions. Okay, so now that you have a good sense of what's going on with the data, the second thing I want you to do is just go in with the game plan, knowing that if the prompt of the question is not very precise, then that means you have complete freedom to estimate. sometimes that is what you must do in order to save the amount of time needed to get through the entire test. So I want you to, like I said, go in with the game plan to estimate whenever the prompt is not precise. That is going to present itself to questions like, what is X closest to? What is approximately the value? All of those are green lights for estimation, and you want to make sure you take advantage of that. Thing that's gonna be really helpful for you when it comes to conquering the data interpretation questions is just memorizing some fraction decimal conversions on the spot. It's going to make a huge difference. Okay, so what do I mean by that? I mean knowing that 1/2 is 50%, 1/3 is 33%, 1/4 is 25%. And you might be saying, well, yes, Ashley, that is easy. Yes, those are the easy ones. I want you to know that 1/5 is 20%, that 1/6 is 18%, that 1/7 I think is 14%. You wanna check that? 14.28, the consulting lifestyle has served me well. 1/8, 12.5%, 1/9, that is 11%, 1/10 is 10%, 1/11 is 9%. I really recommend that you actually memorize up until 1/15th, and then, you know, that's just gonna be something in your back pocket when need be. I don't know when you'll ever need to know that 1/7 is 14.28% again, but it will come in handy, I promise you, on this test. The last thing that I want you to keep in mind when it comes to doing well on the data interpretation questions is to be resourceful. There's more than one way to solve a question, and don't be afraid to use what you have in front of you. I'm talking about that piece of paper. Sometimes you might have a question that asks you how many of the little bars are above a certain threshold. Well, you can just take that piece of paper and put it up to the threshold and then count. Boop, boop, boop. 3. You know what? No shame. Be resourceful. Use your brain and whatever you have with you to be able to just make attacking these problems as easy as possible. That is something that's going to serve you really well in the grad school context. Being resourceful is one of the best skills that I recommend really leveraging, because schools tend to have a lot of resources and they don't always have like a step-by-step guide to how to take advantage of them. So it's going to be really important that you look around and that you try to use as much as possible to achieve your goals. In this certain case, the goal is to get the question right, but like I said, this extends to your life in grad school as well. If this video was helpful for you, please give me a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and let me know in the comments below, what are some things that have helped you get ready for data interpretation tests? And if you have any memorization tricks, let me know also in the comments below, because that's gonna help the Brilliant AF community to really kind of build and get stronger. So that's all I have for today. If you have any other video suggestions, let me know in the comments below. Feel free to reach out at Ashley Freeman on Instagram and Twitter, and I will see you next time.